Everyone in life needs a nemesis. Mine? That's easy. Chris Cuomo. Hillary Clinton has some thoughts about her old political opponent, Bernie Sanders. Quote, he was in Congress for years, Clinton said of Sanders in a Hulu documentary of her political career, adding, he had one senator support him. Nobody likes him. Nobody wants to work with him. He got nothing done. He was a career politician. It's all just baloney. And I feel so bad that people got sucked into it, end quote. Nobody likes him. He got nothing done. Baloney. Sidebar. Baloney is the second worst lunch meat. The worst lunch meat is pimento loaf. It's bologna with olive chunks. And yes, my mom used to make me pimento loaf sandwiches every damn day. And sidebar. Yes, Clinton's attacks do seem to come a little bit out of nowhere. After all, she's not running for president in 2020 yet. I kid, or do I? And generally speaking, she hasn't been super involved in the day-to-day back and forth of the Democratic presidential campaign. But scratch the surface even slightly and it becomes very clear that A, Clinton and Sanders have never really gotten along, and B, neither has been all that secret about their feelings for the other. So all the way back in 2014, which feels like a millennium ago, as it was becoming increasingly clear that Clinton was going to run for president in 2016, Sanders emerged as a leading critic of the former senator, secretary of state, and first lady. Quote, I have a lot of respect for Hillary Clinton, Sanders told the Washington Post back then, but then he added this part. Quote, if she does run, will she be as strong as the times require in taking on the billionaire class that has so much power? I'm not sure that she will be. Will she be as strong as needs be to address the crisis of climate change? I'm not sure that she will be. Will she be as strong as needs be to take on the power of Wall Street? I'm not sure she will be, end quote. And the feud really picked up steam in the early-ish days of the 2016 Democratic primary fight when it became clear that Sanders was going to be a far stronger challenger to Clinton than anyone, especially her campaign, initially suspected. While Sanders attacked Clinton only sparingly during the long run-up to that 2016 nomination fight, it was very clear to anyone paying attention that his entire candidacy was premised on being the anti-Clinton. Where she was establishment, politically cautious, and status quo, he was idealism and unapologetic liberalism. Sanders embodied, and still embodies, all of the pent-up angst and anger of the liberal left directed at the supposed centrism, elitism, and a bunch of other isms out there at the Clintons. Sanders was offering a break from their dynastic reign, and Hillary Clinton knew it, and yeah, she didn't like it. Clinton's initial reaction to the rise of Sanders was to swat him away dismissively, the way I swat away Andrew Yang jump shots. Boom, roasted. Here's Clinton in a primary debate with Sanders delivering the smackdown on his professed admiration for the healthcare system of Denmark.
I think what Senator Sanders is saying certainly makes sense in the terms of the inequality that we have, but we are not Denmark. I love Denmark. We are the United States of America.
Like I said, way dismissive. As the campaign wore on and on, the daggers became less cloaked. At an April 2016 debate, Sanders bluntly said this.
I do question her judgment. Do we really feel confident about a candidate saying that she's going to bring change in America when she is so dependent on big money interests? I don't think so.
Even after the primaries officially ended in June 2016 and it was clear that Clinton had in fact beaten Sanders, the Vermont senator held off for weeks on endorsing Clinton. He eventually did so roughly 2 weeks before the Democratic National Convention, but it was clear that some bad feelings remained, as CNN wrote at the time, quote, there appeared to be little natural chemistry between Clinton and Sanders and their body language was noticeably stiff. The two avoided physical contact after first walking on stage together, and Sanders, in his 30-minute speech, repeatedly mentioned Clinton by name without acknowledging that she was standing next to him looking on, end quote. Good times, good times. In the wake of her stunning loss to Donald Trump that November, Hillary Clinton repeatedly made clear that she believed Sanders' attacks on her during the primary and his lukewarm support during the general election played a central role in her defeat. In her 2017 memoir of the race that was entitled, What Happened? Clinton slammed the, quote, innuendo in impugning my character, end quote, by Sanders, and added that it did, quote, lasting damage, end quote, to her candidacy. And time hasn't really healed those wounds. In an interview with Howard Stern in late 2019, Clinton said that she didn't hate Sanders, she said she didn't hate anybody, but did note that the Vermont senator, quote, hurt me, there's no doubt about it, and I hope he doesn't do it again to whoever gets the nomination. Once is enough, end quote. Add it all up and you get this. Clinton's recent attacks on Sanders aren't an exception, they're actually the rule between these two. And that is the point. We make new point episodes every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. Check them all out.